Welcome back to Infinity Platter. I hope you're having a lovely day so far. Today, we're going to make one of the healthiest and most versatile breakfasts, overnight chia and oat pudding. This breakfast bowl is rich in fiber, carbohydrates, protein, sugars, omega fats, calcium, potassium, probiotics, and so much more. So it's a perfect breakfast to kickstart your day. There are countless ways you can make overnight oats. But first, I'm going to show you a standard base that you can use to make them all, and then also show you three basic flavors, after which you can let your creativity loose and make any flavor you like. For the standard base, which you can use to make all the overnight oats, which makes two portions, you're going to need oats, milk, yogurt, chia seeds, and honey. If you want a vegan version, you can replace the milk with various options like soy, oat, almond, or even coconut milk. And you can replace the yogurt with coconut yogurt. You can adjust the ratio of milk and yogurt depending on how thick or runny you want your pudding to be. And similarly, you can adjust the ratio of the honey or maple syrup depending on how sweet you want your pudding to be. So the three flavors that we're making today are chocolate, banana cinnamon, and peanut butter. Let's start with the chocolate. So in a big bowl, I'm going to add the oats, the chia seeds, the cocoa powder, vanilla, milk, yogurt, and honey. And then mix it all up. Don't worry if the texture seems runny. It's going to rest overnight in the fridge, and your oats and chia are going to absorb all the liquid in this mixture. So once that's fully mixed, cover it and leave it in the fridge overnight. So similarly, for the other two, we're going to combine all the ingredients together, cover them up and put them in the fridge overnight. A batch last night, and this is how they look. This is the chocolate, this is the banana cinnamon, and this is the peanut butter. This is the consistency that I like it, but like I mentioned before, if you want it thicker or runnier, please adjust the ratio of the milk as you like. Also, you can make them in mason jars like this, cover it up, leave it in the fridge, and they'll be good for up to 2 to 3 days. For the toppings, I usually like fresh fruit, coconut flakes, and dry fruits. So I make my own dry fruit and nut mix. In this, we have almonds, walnuts, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, pecans, goji berries, and flax seeds. You can add any dry fruit or nut of your choice. So these are some of my favorite toppings, but you are free to use whatever fresh fruit, dry fruit, nuts that you prefer. For the chocolate chia pudding, the toppings I'm going to use today are bananas, raspberries, strawberries, cherries, the nut mixture, cacao nibs, and coconut flakes. For the banana cinnamon pudding, I'm going to use bananas, blueberries, and our nut mixture. For the peanut butter pudding, I'm going to use bananas, strawberries, blueberries, and our nut mixture. So we just finished the setup for our photos. And don't worry, Alan and I didn't forget about the photography workshop we have for you. So yeah, it's time for me to try it now. Okay. Oh guys, I feel like I'm so healthy and strong already. So that's it for today. I hope these healthy, nutritious breakfast bowls become a part of your everyday life. It sure is mine, and I feel extremely healthy and refreshed and energetic throughout the day when I eat these for breakfast. When you do make them, don't forget to tag me at Infinity Platter on Instagram, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on all my future recipes and adventures. And as usual, all the recipes are in the description boxes below. See you next week.